Hi everyone, and welcome to our witch painting tutorial. This is Free Arts Academy, where art is for everyone. Please like and subscribe to our channel if you enjoy this video. Start with gray and a large flat brush. Paint a shape like we have here using gray, with a slight point and angle. This will end up being a house in the background. Don't obsess over perfection here. Make sure you get some good coverage on your canvas with this gray color. You don't want any canvas poking through. Next, you'll need black and a flat brush. Outline the edges of the house on the bottom with one line coming straight up from the point. Follow our lead. Next, we'll be using burnt orange, brown, and a large flat brush. Start to get some coverage on the middle ground by using a bigger brush and putting down some burnt orange, just like you see us doing here. You do not have to obsess over perfection. A lot of this is going to be getting covered up as we move forward. We just want to get some good color on the ground using some nice autumn colors. Let's add some brown to the mix now. Blend as you see fit and work while the paint is wet. Cover the rest of the canvas. Let's switch over to leaf green and use a fan brush. With your fan brush horizontal, use quick and short upward brush strokes to quickly create a few patches of grass. You don't need to cover the entirety of the ground. Use a light touch, just create a few patches of grass here and there. It's time to let your painting dry before moving on. Use light brown, which is brown with a dash of white and yellow, and a flat brush to create a tree trunk like we are here. While the paint on the tree trunk is still wet, lightly drag some darker brown through the trunk. It'll quickly create some texture on the tree. Now you'll need brown and a larger round or filbert brush. Use a stamping motion with brown to add the first layer of leaves. Do not worry about perfection here, just stamp on some color. While the paint is still wet, layer in some light orange. And let's do this one more time with bright orange. Now you'll need a small flat detailer brush and burnt orange paint. Follow our lead to create pumpkins scattered on the ground. Nice work. It's time to let your painting dry before moving on. Once the first layer of paint on your pumpkins is dry, go in again with a brighter orange. Follow our lead to fortify the color of your pumpkins. Use yellow ochre like you see here to add highlights to some spots of the pumpkins. You don't want to highlight everything, just where you think the light would be touching the top of the pumpkins. This part is optional. You can use a small detailer brush to outline the tree trunk in dark brown. This is a quick way to separate the tree trunk from the background and give it a little depth. Let's use black and a small round brush to create the witch's cape. Follow us. It's basically a triangle shape. At a certain point, you can start adding light gray as we are here, so that you get some depth and dimension and some texture to this witch's cape. Now we'll need dark brown and a small brush. Let's give our witch some brown hair. If you like, you can add some tan or light yellow before the paint dries to add some highlights to the hair. Let's take some time to work on the witch's hat using gray and black. Once you're through with the hat, use peach and brown or any skin tone you really like to make a tiny hand poking out from the side of the cape. This little hand is going to be holding a witch's broom, as you'll see shortly. Let's use light yellow or white to add a broom handle. For this part, you'll need a detailer brush, black, brown, and gray. Use thin, wavy, wispy lines like we have here to create the broom bristles. Use a bit of brown to add some shadow behind our witch. Now we'll need light gray and a small detailer brush. We are going to carefully paint some simple windows in the background. Sorry for the shaky camera, it was very windy when I was filming this. Follow our lead and our angles to create windows. Add just a dash of black to a leaf green color to make a dark green. Be sure to use a nice half inch flat brush here. Paint this side of the house with dark green. Avoid painting over the stuff in the foreground. Just be as careful as you can. No worries if you don't get it all. Mix leaf green with gray to paint the last wall. Be careful to not paint over anything in the foreground. Next, you'll need burnt orange and a small detailer brush. Use a stamping motion to place some lighter leaves on the tree with this color. Using the same detailer brush and yellow ochre paint, use the same method to add a few even brighter leaves. Depending on your preferences, you may need or want to paint another layer on the sides of the house for boldness of color. Next, we'll use brown and a tiny liner brush like you see here. Embellish the pumpkins by adding lines showing the ridges. Now we'll be using leaf green and a tiny liner brush. Let's give each of these tiny pumpkins a little green stem. Next, you'll need brown and a liner brush. Outline the tree trunk with brown and add tiny, wavy vertical lines to the trunk to create some easy, quick texture. Grab some burnt orange and a detailer brush. Let's add leaves with this color using curved dashes across the foreground. Grab some light yellow and a detailer brush. We're simply going to fortify the color of the broom handle. Sometimes mistakes happen. We ended up repainting our hand and outlined it so that it made anatomical sense. Use black and a tiny liner brush to outline a few things. This is a quick way to add depth. In the same way, carefully outline the pumpkins. This is an easy way to make them stand out from the foreground. Add the last layers of leaves in light or dark colors until you're happy with the tree's look. Great work! You finished a witch walking painting tutorial. Be sure to sign your work, and we'll see you next time.